In February 2020, Wuhan was quiet and cold, but at the same time, attracted the attention of the whole world.
What on earth are you doing? Why are these scenes so bright? How can the background music be so sentimental?
Because this is the way it should be.
It doesn't matter. Now you go change it bit by bit according to my request. Lower the contrast of the scene, making it a bit yellow and dark.
Okay, fine. Got it, sir.
Oh, yes, that's it, mate. And change the dubbing. There is a word. Let me see. It's at the tip of my tongue. Oh, yes. Ghost Town. What a fucking genius I am.
In February 2020, most cities in Hubei province with population of nearly 60 million announced their lockdown, including Wuhan. I was driving to interview the pandemic-stricken area and found that it was like a ghost town the whole way. A year later, now, I'm interviewing Hubei province people once again along the same route. Only by communicating more with the local people can I understand what is really happening here. Why on earth did you edit the interview like this? Is there any objectivity in your news reports? But
that's exactly what this person said. It doesn't matter. Can't you just add more silent scenes and dubbing, then cut out anything that does not make sense to the facts?
I met a medical worker. At that time, the authorities still forced them to do unfamiliar work in the community.
Hello? 你们还会跑路吗？送餐吗？嗯，协和医院的这一个医生的用餐，每天住一次，晚上一次。当时我感觉到我们一动什么没有吃的，如果说医护人员没有吃的和我们这个病情就完了，这控制不了了，对不对？但是我赶紧把治疗，我可能在武汉市到处流动，整天马路都是我的。You
mad? Why do you say that? Stop him when you have to. It's forced labor. Do you understand forced food delivery? It's forcing others to risk their lives.
But I think he did it voluntarily, sir.
It doesn't matter.
我最开心的就是我女儿已经上大学了。恭喜你啊，他们就今年吗？对，太好了。上的幼师。有了这么棒的父亲，我不棒，我真的不棒，我真的很不棒。你为武汉还有中国做的事儿。
That's it? Match his emotion with the previous dialogue and then add this part. Say he's not allowed to raise children.
On the street, I met an unemployed delivery man who told me that during the outbreak, he was forced to take charge of the food delivery in the hospital at great risk.
我不忘，我真的不忘，我真的很不忘。中国加油，武汉加油。Yes.
Even though he has to recite the slogans that were indoctrinated in his mind all the time.
Hello，你好。你好。很高兴认识你。我来做美甲，在年初的时候可能会受到影响。会，肯定会。因为当时为什么搬下来，就是没有任何的收入，然后还要支付员工的工资和房租，就这段时间的压力会比较大。在疫情前，我刚刚买了房子。恭喜。对，因为我跟 我老公准备结婚嘛，但是我就很无意间，就非常无意的点点点，因为当时我买房子的房贷没下来，其实是所有的贷款都不能再碰了。然后我当时就看了一下，有个很好的活动， 当时给到我的那个贷款的额度是22万，就是他很扶持武汉的商户，我就把他贷出来了，然后就去交房租啊什么的，所以当时补了一款就蛮好，房贷也没有受影响，然后他的贷款也被我贷出来了。
That's it, mate. Keep it there. The pandemic has brought a devastating blow to China's economy. No one came here. The rent is so high, no one can even run a shop or hold a wedding.
But she said there was help later on.
It doesn't matter. That's a blow, a huge blow from the pandemic. Half of the small enterprises went out of business. Just show us in the video the data on the economic downturn in the first half of the year. Delete the reopening scenes. Just keep that part.
The coronavirus has severely damaged China's economy. In the first quarter of 2020, the economic index dropped by 6.8%, with more than half of the small shops closed. We visited a shop on the spot.
没有任何的收入，然后还要支付员工的工资和房租，就是那段时间的压力会比较大。在疫情前，我刚刚买了房子，因为当时我买房子的房贷没下来，其实是所有的贷款都不能再碰了。
Due to the impact of the pandemic,Many small shops cannot repay their loans, and even their normal lives cannot be sustained.
This 医院我也听了很多人来这里，然后有的人就这边很多的，对。
这边医院的话，那些这都人多的话，就当时的话，疫情当中没得这多人。
所以现在感觉怎么样？你觉得现在的武汉怎么样？
现在武汉都一切都安好，反正都
安安好好的。
You think they're living a normal life? How can they live a normal life? Silence them.
But they didn't say anything wrong, sir.
It doesn't matter. Can't you just insert a scenery shot in the middle? Adjust the light effect. Change the content. Don't you understand what to write in this part?
I try to ask ordinary people on the street how their lives have been after a year and whether they had recovered. But most of them chose to remain silent. It is not hard to find that although the streets are full of people now, people's choking and frightening feeling is yet to dissipate. They still fear the uncertainty for the future, worrying that the pandemic will come yet again. The fear of the virus.
You think they're living a normal life? The pandemic has brought a devastating objectivity in your news reports because this is the way it should be.
But this is the way it should be.
It doesn't matter.